Welcome to the Agrico channel. I am Jitendra Kumar Naik from Odisha University of Agriculture and Technology. First of all, thank you very much for your support. And based on your suggestion, I want to increase the letter size so that it will be easy to read and understand. Okay. So let's start the today's topic. Today's topic is elements of experiment. Experiment means whatever the research. Let us now, I am pursuing my PhD. Whoever doing his or her PhD or MSc, they are doing experiment. And remember, experiment is conducted in either field. Whatever the experiment is conducted either in field or in lab. But remember, after this completion of the experiment, the data analysis will be must. The data analysis, it is a statistical procedure. Without data analysis, without statistician, without experimental design, there is no meaning of experiment. Okay, that means if I am growing two varieties A and variety B in an experiment, and the result is B, the yield A is greater than B. This is the the grain yield is highest in rice variety A as compared to rice variety B. But without data analysis, I cannot say that A is better than B. Remember, without analysis, without data analysis, without experimental design, I cannot tell that A is better than B. Okay, I will say. So before going to this topic, I want to share something. Okay, so let us we are going to a picnic. Okay, in picnic we have arranged a meal. Okay, so there are two types of students are there. One is non-vegetarian student and another is vegetarian student. Okay, for non-vegetarian student, rice, then dal, and for non-veg, mutton is arranged. Okay, but for vegetarian people, rice and dal and some fry, like potato fry is arranged. Okay, but we know for picnic, everybody there should be compulsory. They will apply like this is 150 rupees. Rupees 150. This is compulsory. This 150 rupees will be collected from non-veg student as well as from veg student. Okay. So if I will calculate the price for meal as non-veg student is eating mutton, so this price is approximately 200 rupees. But the veg people, this price will be 100 rupees. Yes or no? Yes. So that the average will be 300 by 2 is equal to 150 rupees. Yes or no? Yes. So now you think the non-veg student is eating 200 rupees. But he is giving 150 rupees. He is eating 200 rupees but giving only 150 rupees. He is giving 150 rupees. Yes or no? So now here the difference here, he is eating, how much is he eating? Extra 50 rupees. Yes or no? But he is eating less 50 rupees. Or we can say the best student is eating 100 rupees but giving 150. That means the best student is giving 50 rupees extra. Okay, so we can say here the price difference, though they are giving the same price 150, but the according to the eating process, the price difference becomes 200 minus 100. It is 100 rupees the difference. Yes or no? So I can say there is partiality between non-veg student and veg student. Yes or no? Because here non-veg is getting a profit of 50 rupees, whereas the best student is getting a loss of 50 rupees. Yes. So remember, in any experiment, we have to minimize. We have to minimize this partiality. Okay. We have to, in any experiment, we have to minimize this partiality. So here, how I can manage? Let us take this example. So now let us take. Here, let us, in initial case, the mutton is 5 pieces. How many pieces is mutton? 5 pieces of mutton was distributed to the non-best student initially. Now, let us decrease this 5 pieces to 3 pieces. Now, each people will get 3 pieces of mutton. That means, now the price of this 200 will decrease. Now, let us, this price will decrease to 170 rupees. Okay? But in case of veg student, we will add extra item. In veg, we will add extra item. Let us, this is anything sweet. Any sweets? Sweets will be distributed to the veg students only. Okay? So then now the price, it becomes 100 to, it will increase to 130. Yes or no? So now the price difference will be 170 minus 130 is equal to 40 rupees. Yes or no? So here you see, initially the difference is 100 rupees, then the difference becomes 40 rupees. Again, I will say the mutton becomes 3 pieces to 2 pieces. Now the price will decrease. Here I will supply some cold drinks to the vegetarian people, so that the difference will also decrease. That means now in this process, I will decrease the partiality. I am minimizing the partiality. I am minimizing the difference. Yes or no? So thereby I am also minimizing the partiality between these two students. One is non-best, another is vegetarian. Okay. So this is the basic principle. This is the basic principle behind any experimental design or any experiment, whether it may be agriculture or non-agriculture. Okay. So here we want to see what are the elements of experiment. There are four phases of experiment. Okay, we can say there are four elements of experiment. What are the four elements? One is selecting. Here, this is selecting the material. Selecting the material, or we can say this is the treatment. Selecting the material or treatment. That means here we can say any plant breeding student, he can take the variety. He can take the variety as the material on which, this variety upon which he want to do any experiment. Okay. So now here specifying the character, here we will specify the character to measure. Which character I want to measure? For variety, let us say we will tell the grain yield. Which one is? Grain yield or plant height or plant height. Which are the different characters which were taken? Okay, so for variety means, so here we will variety 1, variety 2, variety 3. What is the grain yield? What is the plant height? What is the plant height? These are the characters. These are the specified characters, and this is the material or treatment upon which I want to do the experiment. Okay. Yes. Now, these to decide, we can easily decide based on our purpose of the study, based on our purpose of experiment, we can easily decide which material or which treatment I want to take. As well as, based on this purpose, I can say which character I want to take for this variety. Whether it may be grain, plant height, duration, or its habit of growing, whatever else. This is very easy to decide by an agronomist. Yes or no? These two things can be easily decided. Can be easily decided by an agronomist. whether it may be agronomist or any other agriculturalist. Okay, easily decided. This is based upon us. Okay. We will decide. But now we see the third and fourth. This is procedure of measurement. Procedure how you will measure the characters. How you will measure the characters. First thing, hypothesis. Hypothesis means, let us, I have taken the hypothesis B1 is better than B2. Which one is better? B1 variety is better than B2. So whether this hypothesis is right or wrong, whether this hypothesis is proved, I have to prove yes my hypothesis is true, or whether it is disproved. This is done by the analysis. This is done by the analysis. Statistical analysis will be done. Whatever the those measurements we have taken, whether these are right or wrong, to according based on the hypothesis what I have taken. Remember, these two things, how we are measuring the characters and whether the measurements are to be used for proved or disproved the hypothesis, these are done by the statistician. These two processes are done by the statisticians. So statistical analysis should be done. That is why these two things are known as design of an experiment. Design of an experiment. Remember, what are those? How to measure and whether the measurement of what we have taken, that is satisfied with our hypothesis or not. This is called as the design of an experiment. Okay. So basically, this design of experiment, we can say it has three essential elements. What are those? First one is estimation of error. Then after estimation of error, we can go for the control of error. Last one is interpretation of whatever the result is obtained. Interpretation of the result. Okay, remember, always remember what it will be asked in various SRF GRF examinations. What are the three elements of design of experiment? Okay, so the three elements are estimation of error, then control of error, and then interpretation of the result. Okay, this is proper interpretation of result. Okay, so now let us think, what is error? What do you mean by error? What is it? What do you mean by experimental error? What is the estimation of error? So now we will study what is the error. Okay. Here, the estimation of error. Error means, here we can say the experimental error. If I will say estimation of error, that means the difference among the estimation of error, I can say the difference among the experimental unit, which are treated alike. What is the difference among the experimental plots which are treated alike? For example, let us, this is a lamb. This is a lamb, okay? So I have divided into four parts. This is part 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. So there is variety. I have taken variety. Two variety, one is A, another is B. Okay? So what happened? I will grow A variety here in first, and then I will grow variety here in second. B. Okay, so now let us remember. What is the property? If I will say, what are the property? Or 1 is equal to 7, 2 is equal to 4. That means there is no difference between 1 and 3 based on the environmental characteristics, whether it may be soil characteristics or any other climatical condition. There is the 1 and 3, they are same. The property, the soil property of 1 is similar to the 3, whereas here the soil property 2 is similar to the 4. So we can say there is no difference between 1 and 3, there is no difference between 2 and 4 land. This is land, okay, that means land 1 is same as land 3, land 2 is same as land 4, okay. So now, here again, there is a chance of, now you say, there is difference between 1 and 3, 1 and 2, 3 and 4, okay. समझ में आया? अभी first वाला जो land है, वो same है as compared to 3, ये दोनों same है, ये दोनों, I can say here, ये दोनों same है, whereas, ये दोनों same है, based on the property, okay. So now, I will grow A on land 1, I will grow B on land 2. Now I will take the data, the grain yield. Grain yield of A and grain yield of B. Okay, so now, again, I will grow the B in land 3 and A in land 4. Okay, because there is no, I have already told that we should minimize the partiality. Suppose this part of land is more fertile. Yes, this part of land is more fertile and this part of land is less fertile. This is more fertile, this is less fertile. Okay. So here see, if I will grow A in more fertile land, then automatically the yield of A will be greater than yield of B. Yes or no? Yes. So there is partiality. Yes or no? I am biased. A is favored because A is grown in the fertile land, whereas B is grown in the less fertile land. So then here I am doing the partiality. That is why I have to grow B on the same land and A on the less fertile land. Okay. So now I will take the data here B2. I will take the data A1 plus A4 and I will take the mean value. What is this? Is the A mean value. Again, I will take the B2 and B3 by 2, I will take the mean value. Yes or no? Yes. Because A1 is grown in fertile land, more fertile land, so maybe the yield is high. Here A4 is grown in less fertile land, so yield is less. So I will take the mean or the average value. Here also like that, I will take the B value. Here B2 is less fertile land, whereas B3 is more fertile land. I will take the average value of B. Okay. So I will say Now, if in this case A is greater than B, then I can say A is better than B. I can say A is better than B. Okay. But now you see, in this case, but in a practical condition, this land has different characteristics. Yes or no? In a field condition, we know that every part of the land has a different property. It may be based on nutrient, or it may be based on the pH. You know, if the land is slopy land, if the land is slopy land, then here the water law condition will be there. In lowland condition, water law condition will be there. Yes or no? Likewise, the nutrient variation will be there. So, what happened? In a land, if I will grow same variety, you can say. So in a land, I am growing. Here one is A. Same variety is also grown in just side to the plot. Same variety A is just grown to the side plot of. So here we cannot get the same yield. Same yield नहीं मिलेगा क्योंकि there are some variations between these lands. This variation, that means this is a, remember the difference among the experimental plot. Yes or no? Here is experimental plot, two experimental plots which are treated alike. A variety is grown here, this A variety is also grown there, but there is difference between same variety. Here is the variety is same, but the grain yield is different. That is why it is known as experimental error, because this experimental error is due to the difference in experimental plot. Remember, okay. So we have to estimate the experimental error. First thing, we have to estimate the experimental error. And remember, this is also a question which is frequently asked. Remember, I am asking you one question. I have told one is experimental error. Okay? So, experimental error means the error due to the experimental unit or experimental plot. You say, if experimental will be high, it is good or bad? If the experimental error, whatever the experimental error I have found, if the experimental error is high, then it is good for the experimental or bad? It is bad for experimental error. Obviously, if experimental error is there, now here we have seen the A is greater than B. If the experimental error is high, maybe the grain yield of A is high due to the experimental error. Maybe the A is present in more fertile land. That is why the yield is high. Yes, this is known as the experimental error. Here the principle is that if the variety A and B is there, each has equal chance to grow on same land. Yes or no? Same land, they have equal chance. But suppose I have grown A on more fertile land, then automatically A will give more yield. Yes or no? This is the experimental error. So we have to minimize the experimental error. If the experimental error is minimized, now experimental, let us take this example. Experimental error is high and we get A is greater than B. The grain yield of A is greater than A grain yield of B. In second case, experimental error is less, and in this case I will get A is greater than B. Okay. Just think. Here in first case, experimental error is high, and I get the grain yield of A variety is greater than grain yield of B variety. But in second case, I have the experimental error is very less, and I also get the result A, the grain yield of A is greater than grain yield of B. So, which one is right? Both are right? No. Only one first is right? No. Only second one is right. Remember, we have to always minimize the experimental error. So, in both cases, though in both cases, the grain yield of A is greater than grain yield of B. But this case 2, this is right, this is wrong. So always remember, experimental error is inversely proportional to the reliability of an experiment. Experimental error is inversely proportional to the reliability of an experiment. That means, if the experimental error will be high, then we cannot rely upon this experiment. Okay? Here experimental error is high, so we cannot do this experiment. We cannot rely on this experiment. So, if the experimental error is less, then we can rely upon the experimental design. Okay? So, the basic principle is we have to always minimize the experimental error. Remember. So, now the question is how to control the error. How to minimize the error. Now, this control means we have to go over there are different processes. I have already told there are different processes. One is for control of error, there are different processes. One is replication. And another is randomization. Replication I have taken, no? This is replication. Replication means repetition. Repetition, then I will take the average value. Yes or no? We have to go for repetition. Then replication means repetition. Randomization means I have already told each treatment has equal chance to get the same length. Yes or no? Or same place. Randomization means each treatment has equal chance to get a same length. There should be no biasness will be there. Okay? That means here I have taken A, B. Here I will also put A, B. This is wrong because here I have put the B variety always on the right side of the A. Here see, B is on the right side of A. Here also B is present on the right side of A. So this is wrong. So here I have told randomization is there. So here I can say if I will write here A, here B, here also B, here A. This is randomization. Means here A is present only left side, B is present only right side. But in this case, A has a equal chance to be present in left side and right side. B also has equal chance to be present in left side and right side. Yes? So this is known as the randomization. So next, we will go for the interpretation of the result. After whatever the results, let us see here that A grain yield is greater than grain yield of B. So now I will interpret by using some statistical analysis. This is known as the ANOVA table. We will go for ANOVA table. For interpretation of our result, we will go for interpretation of result, we will go for ANOVA table. ANOVA means analysis of variance. Okay? We will say analysis of variance. So now, These are the basic principle how we will take the treatments and how we will arrange the treatments and how to minimize the experimental error. So thank you. In next class we will study about different factors of experiment. Factors, it may be single factor or two factor, three factor, okay, likewise. We will study. Okay? So thank you. If any question is there, then so please comment, and thank you, and stay connected with me.